Good afternoon, everyone. This is Michael Tater with WTOL 11. We are live downtown Toledo right now. Jackson Street and North Erie Street, right in front of police headquarters, where this protest already began getting underway about a half hour ago. We already have probably several hundred people crowding the streets and the sidewalks here downtown. As you can see, plenty of cars coming by honking in support with signs.
Give it up! Give it up! Come on in! Block the street! Shut this down! Block the street! Shut it down! Hood Street! 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 No justice! No racism! No justice!
No peace!
No racism!
Police!
Whose street?
Our street!
Whose street?
Our street!
Whose street?
Our street!
Whose street?
Our street!
Black lives
matter!
Black lives
matter!
Black lives
matter!
Black lives matter! Black lives matter! If I can get you to turn around, get your connections with this man, we got to go ahead. Give yourselves a hand. Can I get some volume? Can everybody hear? Can I get some more volume on this? We look beautiful today. I'm Brother Washington Muhammad. I'm the co-founder of the Community Solidarity Response Network. Many people didn't want us to be here today. Many people thought there would be chaos, but they had no idea that love would get here first. So give yourselves a hand today. Give yourselves a hand. We're gonna start positive. We're gonna stay positive. We're gonna start positive. We're gonna stay positive. I know that there may be somebody in the crowd that wants to break up this unity, so I need you to be vigilant. We're not having that today. We're not having that today. Not on my watch. Not on his watch. Not on her watch. We're not having that today. We're going to talk about police accountability. We're going to talk about what we can do ourselves to make them listen. So every time they have a misstep, we have a consequence for them. Am I right?
Yeah.
It's time to stop asking for permission to speak. Stop asking for permission to defend our community, to defend our women, to defend our children. Police have a duty to protect us, not terrorize us. They have a duty to protect us, not terrorize us. And there's going to be a price, a high price to pay when they come into our neighborhood and abuse our children, to abuse our men. underneath this brother right behind me. I want you to listen to his words. He's going to speak about silent face in the crowd. He's going to talk about the mentality of an activist. Jody, you ready? Let's give our brother a hand. How's everybody doing today? So we don't understand why we're all here, right? We're not here to riot. We're not here to loot. We're not here to destroy this city that needs so much, right? Okay. So, don't say that one more time. I didn't get a response from the audience. We're not here to destroy the city we live in because of injustice. Okay. So this piece is called Silent Face in the Crowd. I wrote it based on what we do here in the community, what we do in our outward community when we travel and stuff like that. I hope this piece resonates with you. So let's begin. Yes. I am an activist. I stand proud with my sign, my pen, my button, my banner, my voice, and believe that I stand behind. You may find me in the streets, on the corner, or marching with other great minds. We have been called names, spit on, tear gas, hoes, dog sicked on us, beaten, maimed, murdered, and braved. All because we believe it's our civil duty, yes, our civil duty, to point out the ones that are to blame. Point out the silent murders they commit, poisoning our pipes with lead and filth, killing the environment, and feeding us food, just feeding us food that never had life in it. Crimes against humanity, that's humanity that makes us sick, bombing women and children, clear-cutting forests, and killing kids, that's killing kids, over a bag of skeletons and sick. Oh, so they can become filthy rich. Why do we care, you might ask, as you sit behind your gate, out in those blood money stacks, gain from such great pain while you build yourself up on the backs of corporate names? Because we are the people. Yes, we are the people. Children, the world, and everyone else, because we want a world with more peace, more freedom of speech, not fear, hate, lies, discrimination, manipulation, and deceit. Why, yes, I was one of us. There are millions, just millions more that have seen our fire, heard our desire. Now burn, yes, burn for something more. More than the spoon-fed media truth that you give to them, you spend to them to corrupt their children to no longer defend them. I am an activist. I stand proud in my resolve. Knowing those that came before me strengthen me when I think I might fall. So join the truth. Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, Frederick Douglass, Rosa Parks, Martin Luther King, Angela Davis, Fred Hampton, Malcolm X, Gordon, yes, Martin Luther King, Jr. God knew that they might fall, but they did, yes, they did, for each, what they did, for each and every, yes, every last one of y'all. No justice!
No peace!
Hands up! Don't shoot! Speak until there's no more breath in my lungs to speak, to see my people's minds, bodies, and souls released from these evil beasts. Thank you. Now you can do better than that. Where's Bruce at? Let's bring up Bruce. We're the Community Solidarity Response Network. We're gonna have Bruce read our mission statement. You gotta know where we come from, how we were formed, and where we're going.
We are the Community Solidarity Response Network of Toledo, formed on November 25th, 2013, the day after it was announced that the killer, a Ferguson, Missouri police officer, a Michael Brown, an unarmed teenager, would not be indicted. We bring awareness to the injustices experienced by black men, women, and children who are disproportionately murdered, attacked, provoked, and harassed by law enforcement. Police brutality has to end. We bring awareness to the fact that most often, police brutality goes without consequence and accountability. Police impunity has to end. We utilize the tactics of protest, civil disobedience, event disruption, and citizen advocacy to give voice to those who are otherwise voiceless. We facilitate progressive community-based events that help to foster self-development, and we discuss measures to hold local leadership accountable to their sworn duties, be they politicians, clergy, law enforcement, educators, etc. We want justice, equal justice under the law. We want justice applied equally to all, regardless of creed or class or color. For all lives to matter, black lives must matter. In the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Peace.
Come on, who can't hear you? Is going to read our guiding principles. In order for us to continue, we got to be mindful that we not hurt ourselves. We got to be mindful that we don't eat our own. We have to be mindful that we don't rot from within. Julian, our guiding principles.
Everybody is here. Give yourself a round of applause.
Reflection must be part of all of it. We learn from our mistakes, and we learn from our victory. Billion asset. Principled struggle can exist in a positive environment. We must be honest with one another by embracing direct and loving communication. Can I get an asset? Love. I'm going to talk to you about love. Love and self-love is practicing every element of all that we do. Love and self-love must be the driver of our work and the indicator of our success. Without this principle and without healing, we will harm each other and undermine our own movement. Can I get an ashe? 360-degree vision. We honor past struggles and wisdom from our elders. I said we honor past struggles and wisdom from our elders. The work we do today builds the foundation of movements of tomorrow. We consider our mark on future generations. Can I get an ashe? Self-care means we build resilient spaces by budgeting time, energy, and resources for living. Self-care is a regular, consistent, and intentional essential practice. Can I get an ashe? The most directly effective people in their own lives should be in leadership at the center of our movement.
I'm gonna wrap it up, sir. Guys, as of right now, the protest continues. It started around 3 o'clock officially as speakers got underway to begin this. I'm going to wrap up and see if I can talk to some of the protesters here as well as some of the speakers leading a very peaceful protest at this time. Again, they started this protest by saying there wasn't going to be any looting, there wasn't going to be any fires, there wasn't going to be any violence of any kind, and that is what is being maintained right now. We'll have a full live report later tonight. I may be back here on Facebook Live before, but if not, we'll have a full live report coming up at 6 on WTOL 11. Everyone stay well, stay in tune.